Thank you, Nikita. President, fellow Toastmasters and guests, good evening to all of you.
Good evening.
All right. Like Nikita said, this session is going to be about how do we tackle table topics. How many of you in this audience are not Toastmasters? Okay, that's wonderful. So first, let me begin by telling you what table topics is. Table topics is nothing but an impromptu speech, something which is delivered without any preparation. So if your boss calls you to the office, or the principal calls you to the office and asks you something, you don't even know what to say, and your answer would be an impromptu speech. It would come right at the top of your hat. You would not have any preparation to answer that. For the girls who come home late at night after curfew, and your mother is standing at the door and says, "Now tell me why you have come," and suddenly you make up a story. Do you know something? I just had an accident over there. And that is your impromptu speech ability. So impromptu is nothing but giving a little speech from the top of a hat. But in Toastmasters, when we give impromptu speeches or table topics, they require a little more preparation. And an impromptu speech, although it is just for 1 to 2 minutes, just 1 to 2 minutes, believe you me, even those 1 or 2 minutes seem an eternity. So long, but that mini speech still requires preparation. It still needs 3 parts to be a good speech. It needs an opening, a body, and a conclusion. So today, what I'm going to do is to give you some ideas as to how to tackle our table topics when it is given to you. There are 4 methods that I am going to run through very quickly. The first is called prep. When you get a topic, you assimilate what has been asked of you and you apply the prep method. What is prep? The first P stands for taking a position. So if somebody asks you, should we raise the fines for traffic offenses in the city? That is a question that you have been asked, and that is your favorite topic. So when you get a question like, should we raise, you have to take a stand, yes or no. That is your position. So when you are tackling a table topic using the prep, you first take position. The R stands for reason. Why am I taking this position? Should I raise, should the fines be raised or not? Yes, there is so much of accidents and people coming the wrong way and hitting the red lights. Yes, there should be an increase in the rate. So that is your reason. So the second, after you take position, you state a reason as to why you have taken that step. The E is the body of your speech. That is the example. You give an example. You were across at a traffic signal and somebody just sped across and hit somebody, and that person was gravely injured and you saw it right in front of your eyes. That has always remained in your mind, and you definitely think the fines should be increased. So here you have given an example. And finally, the final P is you go back to your position, which is your conclusion, and convince the audience, yes, this is my position and this is my reason, and I hope you will agree with my reason. So you go back to your position. So when I said that a table topic should body and a conclusion. In this prep system, the position and the reason is your opening. Your example is the body. And your final position, where you are trying to convince the people that that is right, or you think that is right, and convince it, that is your conclusion. So you see, in this little table topic, where we have used the prep system, we have included an opening, we have included a body, and we have included a conclusion. Now what I'm going to do is, as we go into each system, I'm going to give you a topic, so that somebody will stand up and use this prep system and give me an opening, a body, and a conclusion. This topic I will give you, which fits this: should capital punishment be banned? Should capital punishment be banned? Anybody who would quickly like to just stand in their place and attempt it? Yes, Amit.
Hello, everyone. According to me, I would say it should be banned.
Okay, so Amit has taken a position. Okay, we are going to go through this. He says it should be banned.
Because I believe that every man is born a clean slate. No one is taught how to commit a crime. It's the circumstances that turn a man into a murderer. So what we need to change is the circumstances that man is, and the man will change.
See, he has given you his reason why he has taken that position. And it is a very convincing way to address the audience when you take a stand and you give a strong reason. Anybody would like to continue with? So he has given a fantastic opening. A round of applause to him. Want to give an example of what actually happens. Anybody want to try an example? We have to carry on with Amit's story. He wants it banned, and he says, let's give people a chance to improve, to rehabilitate. So he wants that. Anybody wants to quickly think? Okay. Yes, Charlie.
In the movie Kanun, they have shown that Ashok Kumar is, he's shown to be guilty and he's going to be hanged. But it's actually a lookalike of him who has actually committed the murder. So the reason, so the example I wanted to give of Ashok Kumar was the wrong person would have been hanged.
Yes.
And that is the reason why I agree that capital punishment should be banned, because no innocent should be hanged.
Excellent. So she has given us a story as well as gone to the position, and the story is completed. Now when you give example, a round of applause to Jack. Now when you give examples, where do you find these examples? You know, we say give an example. Where do you find it? The best examples are your own personal stories, something you know. But in a topic like this, hopefully you all don't have a personal example. Okay? So probably what Charushila did, take a scene from a movie, take an item from the newspaper, because the newspapers are full of these dramatic stories. So reading a lot, having news items in your head, if you're a movie buff, having movie scenes in your head, having family examples, not for this topic but for other topics, they are all things that you can take out of from your head and use as examples for your story. Have you all understood this first technique of how to tackle a table topic? Okay, let's move on to the second one. Pendulum. You are given a topic and you don't know what to say. Should I say this or should I say that? These topics are quite sensitive and you can't take a firm stand. So the best thing to do in that situation is speak for and come back and speak against, and in the end you take a neutral position and you can say anything might work. I have just told you my case. Let's take an example. There are too many choices these days. Is it good or is it bad? Now, how do you tackle a topic? But it fits this pendulum. There are too many choices today. Is it good or bad? Oh, I went to the supermarket with my children, and I have four children, and they all went to the biscuit section, and one picked up glucose, one picked up Britannia, one picked. There are so many choices these days on the shelves. I did not know what to do. It is wonderful that they have this choice. But you know, as a mother of four, I just wish there was that Parle G. And they did not have all those choices to make, and they could just pick up a whole box of Parle G and I would be happy. Now you see, as a mother, I'm happy that my children have a choice, but it gets just too much in the supermarket with them tugging and pulling, you know. So I really wish there were no choices. So in this topic, which is slightly sensitive, you go from one side to another. But all in all, that you say as a mother, you really appreciate what your children have today. Choices not only in food, but in life, in careers, as well as how we had none of those. So you, this is the pendulum approach, where you take both sides and then you come to a neutral stand. Now when you get a topic in a contest, you have to quickly, you have about 7 to 10 seconds to decide, how am I going to tackle it? Is it going to be by the prep? Should I take a firm stand and find a reasoned example and take a position? Or should I move like the pendulum, this or that, and stay neutral? And once you take that decision, that will lead you to a path of your speech. And then you will just flow with the speech. Okay? I will give you one example, and maybe we can try somebody who will attempt the pendulum. The topic is men or women. Who is smarter? Yes, try.
Good evening, all. So, according to me, men and women are both kind of smart based on the context.
He's very diplomatic. Already starting right in the middle. Now, both are smart according to him. But now he's going to give you both sides. Carry on.
Based on the context that is put upon in front of them, women are smarter when it comes to the emotions, and men are smarter when it comes to the word or some other kind of logical. I'm not saying that women are not smart when it comes to logical things, but they are smarter when it comes to the emotional things.
Alright, so he gave you men are more logical, women are more emotional, and he. Please have a seat. Give him a round of applause. Now, you can substantiate this with an example as to how the women are emotional and how it is a positive thing for them to be emotional because it bonds with their kids, and how the man's logic in the house keeps them on track and they don't pick up. So, expand that same concept with an example, because you don't want your table topic to be under 1 minute, right? So if you just start that both are equal and women are emotional and men are logical, you're going to finish your table topic in 20 seconds and you want it to go between 1 and 2 minutes. So whatever your thought is, make up an example on the spur of the moment. This example works even over here. Okay? So when you go from side to side, substantiate it, increase it with an example. Is this technique clear? Yeah? Both sides. Alright. The third technique that I would like to share with you is one that we call the past, the present and the future. You have a timeline. Okay? So for example, what is your happiest childhood memory? Somebody asks you, what is your happiest? So instead of going straight into what is your happiest memory, which will be the present, you can start with the past and say that this is where I grew up, in a small family, in a small town. So you're talking about your past. And then you come into the present, which is the question itself, and say, you know, but from that, this one incident really remains fresh and vivid in my mind. That was the week that my grandmother visited us for a whole 10 days. And the things I learned from her and the things she taught me will forever remain fresh in my mind. So that is the memory. And what is the future? Is today I'm a working woman. And my memories have helped me to be the person I am. That is your future. So you take a topic and move it from the past to the present to the future. And some topics lend us that ability to do this, moving from past, present, and future. Okay, I'm going to give you a choice to talk on this. How has internet changed our lives? That would be a topic for past, present, and future. Anybody quickly want to attempt this? How has it, yes?
Now the era of 80s and 90s. What an era it was. How nostalgic that era was. The era of letter writing, the era of face-to-face communication. And now we come to the present era of 2018. Internet was started in the year 2001 by Tim Berners-Lee. And as the internet started adapting, as there were many adaptions in the field of internet, as there were technological advancement, its usage, its utilization also began to increase. And its utilization increased to that extent that most of us are disgraceful with that. Most of us have been, addicted to that phase of internet.
Now move to the future. You don't know about
it. Yes, future. So the good point, as I said, information, it has provided with lot of information. But in future, if you want to reduce the negative impacts like addiction and all, then that can be reduced by limiting the usage of internet.
Excellent. Give him a round of applause. So you go to the past, you come to the present, and you say you don't know what the future is going to hold. Excellent topic. Again, one tip. And my tip remains constant, and that is to personalize every story. When you make it that it is only a scientific and you but if you said, you know, in those days when my grandfather used to handwrite everything and make it personal things, you know, he used to write letters to me and I would wait 1,000 miles away to receive that letter. That was the mode of communication. Today I have nothing to look forward to. So make it a personal story of a family. Every time you bring in family and your own person, it touches an emotion and it connects with the audience. Okay? And the final technique is association. Association is the simplest, most direct. Somebody says to you, which sport do you like? And immediately you assault. A light bulb goes on and you say, tennis. You don't even have to think. Football, cricket, whatever it is. And in association, you do not complicate things. You keep it very simple. You don't say, you know, but yesterday Sachin did really well, so I think cricket should be it. And Federer lost, so I think tennis should go down the drain now for a while. is your passion? Association is something about yourself and your passion. Immediately, what festival do you like? What sport do you like? The answer should be quick. Festival, I love kites, so kite flyers. And you build your story through association. Okay, it is a very direct way, and I'm going to ask somebody to talk on very quickly off the hat. Which is your favorite festival? Somebody from this side. Yes, yeah, yes, come.
My favorite festival, I like lights. My favorite festival is Diwali.
Sankrant. Yeah, because kites are associated with Sankrant. Lights. Oh, I'm so sorry. I heard kites. Kites is buzzing in my head. He loves lights, and so he connects it with Diwali. And he will build a story of Diwali, the sweets, why he enjoys it, all the frills and things. But he already associated his like immediately with the topic, and this is called association. So we have prep, pendulum, past, present and future, and association. And I hope you will all attempt a table topic and not be afraid. And if in the past you have had a fear of table topics, let those bygones be bygones. Leave it aside. Today is a new day, and today you are going to attempt table topics like never before. So do okay, so forget the past, think of the past, your fear, and you are going to attempt it. So do we have how many minutes? 8 minutes? 20 minutes, so we have about 8 minutes, so maybe we can have 4 speakers. Alright. So now, who wants to volunteer for the first speech? Come on, quickly. So let's have 4. You've already had a chance. Come. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is, I've got topics which are around these 4 methods, and you can decide. Are you? You're not a business person, right? No. No general. Now I'm giving a contest type topic, okay? Because he's a Toastmaster, I'm going to give him a topic that might come in a contest. No general can fight his battle alone. No general can fight his battle alone. Now, for the audience, because this is not really a table topics where we are going to have winners, but for the audience, what style would you quickly choose? Prep. Perfect. Prep is the perfect thing. No general can fight his battles alone.
Gentlemen, tonight we dine in hell. Keyword, gentlemen. I will not say, or a general will not say, I can do it alone. Wars can only be won if people are fighting as one, together. Take any example of a war in which, or let me give you an example. World War I. It began with a fight between the Austrian and a very small country of Sarajevo. It's called a small country of Bosnia by a crisis called the Sarajevo crisis. So the Austrian army was a big kingdom, and they attacked the small country of Bosnia. But the Bosnians were one. They were together. And you know what? The Bosnians held their grounds. Another example of this is the Maratha kingdoms fighting against the mighty army of Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb's army was larger, it had better inventory, it was better managed, but the Marathas were one. They believed in their general, the great Shivaji Maharaj. And that is why they held their own, they held their forts. So, general cannot win a war on his own. Thank you.
Okay, excellent. He used the prep system, the method, and he took a position that it cannot be won alone. He gave you an example of the Marathas, and he said it cannot. Now, in the final position, a tip that I would like to give you is give some meaning. So appeal to the audience that when we work, let us work together. Okay, because it's unity, we're trying to think. And after all, when you tell a story, if there is disconnect, then it really doesn't involve the audience. So to finally involve the audience, reach out to them and say, you know, you are all champions, but you cannot really fight unless you have a whole army with you. Okay, so make it personalized. Alright, excellent. Let's go to the next. Anybody who's going to come here? Yeah? The topic is credit cards, bane or boon? Good or bad? Credit cards, bane or boon? If you've got a topic like that, what? You would choose a pendulum. Okay, very clear. So this is what you have to practice, that when you get a topic, you quickly decide, what am I going to choose? What style and what technique am I going to do? Over to you.
Good evening, everybody. So credit cards, boon or bane? I'll say credit cards in today's era is a good as well as a bad thing. It is a very useful thing for people who make good use of credit cards, who are in control of their shopping, who know how to use, how much to use, where to use, when not to use. If you are going out for a date, probably it's a good to use opportunity, but in control, wherein you want to impress your friend, girlfriend, boyfriend, whatever. At the same time, you have to be in control so that you can manage your expenses. Do not go over limit. Now, with a credit card, the flip side is that there is very easy probability that you can go overboard and overspend, which in a way can become a big penalty for you because eventually you have to pay and bear the expenses. Credit card can help you save your manage your finances at times, but at other times it can also push you in the situation where it becomes difficult to come out of the financial problems. So to summarize, I would say credit card is the usage of credit card is up to the individual. It is a good and bad as per the situation and as per the individual. Thank you.
Talking about pendulum style. Your body language should show that it is a pendulum style. So when you are talking force and you're telling a story, wow, I've got so many credit cards in my pocket, I can go and buy a gift, I can take somebody to dinner, move to one side. Show the excitement of having that credit card and the positivity. And then you say, you know, change your expression, move to another side, act the pendulum, and say, but what happens in America? Everybody has dozens of that. They overspend, they go into debt, they ruin their lives. You see what I'm saying? So in a pendulum, you show your emotion of one side and the other, and then you come. But I am a balanced man. I use it wisely. You take it. Okay? So a round of applause to him.
Okay, Darshan, I'm going to give you a straightforward one.
You just quickly tell me what you're going to choose from this guy. What gift would you buy your best friend and why? What gift would you buy your best friend and why? What do you think he would use?
BPF.
Yeah, you can have a BPF or an association. Okay, both would work for this kind of question.
So there's a saying that your thoughts lead to your actions, your action leads to your results. So I think a great deed always requires a great thought somewhere, and the best way to develop thoughts is reading books, because they influence us in a way we don't even understand, we don't even recognize. So it's not a voluntary process always. Sometimes a lot of times it's unconscious. So I think I would give my friend a book, something that he is interested about, something that he is passionate about, so that he can fight the odds against himself or the thoughts, the negative thoughts, and overcome them. So I think a book would be a good option. Thank you.
Okay, so here in the past, present, and future, all by association of a book with your dearest friend. Okay, so the past could have been you've grown up together and your mothers used to read you story books, and that's how you have this passion for books. And so it's a no-brainer that today you will gift your best friend a book. Okay, because even as you grow old, that is going to remain a hobby with you for life. So past, present, future, or association. Well, we come to the end of our time. We've had only 3 speakers, but I hope you all have got a gist, an idea of how to handle a table topic when you are called upon. May I have the timer's report, please?
Toastmaster here, 1:45 seconds. Toastmaster, ready? 1:34 seconds. Toastmaster, 50 seconds. 50 seconds.
So Darshan is not qualified. So please vote for the best table topic speaker between meaning and everything. And with that, I hand back to the